What's going on, everybody? My name is Marquise, and this is my first camera. Okay, let me be honest. That's not my first camera. That's more like my third camera. The first two had issues. They broke. The sensors weren't working right, so I had to trade them in, and eventually I got this one. Now, this camera that I had, obviously I had, I'm not using anymore. I'm shooting on something different, clearly. One, two, there you go. This first camera, the problem with the first two cameras were that the sensors were bad. This camera, the sensor was better. It worked and functioned. So the pictures didn't come out blurry. You can see the face clearly, things of that nature. Now, when it came time to actually trying to use the camera, after I realized the first two were faulty, I realized that my pictures were still blurry. The reason was I had limitations. I had limitations on my knowledge of the camera, limitations on what the camera could actually do, limitations on what I knew how to do as far as shooting and things of that nature. So I had to start from scratch, basically. This is the first picture I ever, well, first video I ever shot on said camera. Terrible. Blurry, grainy, but I had the gist down. I knew how to edit fairly well, but you know, you can only do so much when you don't have a whole lot to work with, which is partly because I didn't know how to work this camera. So today we're going to be talking about limitations, and I'm using this camera as an example of limitations. So with limitations, you have things that you can't do, basically. People who can be limited physically, people can be limited mentally, people can be limited spiritually or emotionally, or things can be limiting towards them, i.e. this camera. And the only way to fix that is to actually learn how to work within the limits that you have. It's like going to school for something hands-on. You don't get to just go ahead and experiment all that you want. No, you have controlled situations to help you understand the limits that you have, understand what can be and what can't be done. And the more you learn, the more those limits aren't limiting anymore. And it's the same thing with life, and it's the same thing with things that you have. When I got this camera, I thought I could do everything. I thought I could maneuver how I wanted. I could do what I wanted with the camera. I thought I could go here, go there, go everywhere. But as it turned out, I couldn't. I had to learn how to work the camera. I could edit videos, like I said, but I couldn't really work the camera. I didn't know what stabilization was. I didn't know how to keep my hands steady. I didn't know any of that. I had to learn all of that on the go. So having a tripod helped a lot. I learned how to do a lot via tripod, but I didn't know how to set settings. I didn't know what ISO was. I didn't know what the white balance was. I didn't know any of that stuff. So when I was working with this camera, I couldn't do anything. My videos would come out like this. My pictures would come out like this. There wasn't much I could do. I had to learn how to work it. Now, the thing is this, when I realized how bad I was with the camera, I thought, well, this just isn't for me. And then I saw a video by this channel, DSLR Guide. And I realized he was using the same camera I was using but was getting professional results. So what did that tell me? That told me that I had to go back and learn how to work within the limitations of the camera. That's something he said in the video about why he won't buy a new camera, a better camera. He learned how to work within the limitations. So he knew how to make things look good and look pretty and do things that needed to be done. It's the same thing with life. We're going to have some things that you have to learn how to make look good or make work good. It's not enough to simply just say, well, I have it, it should work like this. If it doesn't work like that, you have to learn how to make it work. Learn how to work within your limitations to break said limitations. I mean, this camera, the Canon Rebel T3i, is entry level. It's not professional. It's not a professional grade camera for video or photography. It's basically just a camera for you to kind of practice and get good at, you know? A school might tell a child in high school to buy it for whatever photography class they have because it's cheap, it's affordable, like $300 in the USA. You can get that relatively cheap and, you know, get to practicing. But for a man to be able to do that professionally, it taught me that I just learned how to work, had to learn how to work the camera. I had to learn where I was weak at, learn how to strengthen those weaknesses, turn them into strengths. I had to learn how to work within what the camera could do. The camera can't go that high up in ISO, so in certain light situations, it's not going to be good, or rather low light situations, it won't be good. But I had to learn all of that. I had to learn how to do all of that. And then I went from making videos like that, from blurry, grainy stuff, to videos like this. It was all a matter of learning how to do what I needed to do. It's great if you learn how to work it. Same thing with any limitation. It's great if you know how to work it. It becomes a strength if you know how to work it. It's like a person who